Hi, and welcome to a Cometa camera tutorial video on your Precision Design Universal Flash. This inexpensive, versatile flash unit is often bundled with a variety of digital cameras from our store, and as such, we get a lot of questions about how to use it. This brief video should answer some of those questions so that you can use your flash more effectively. We offer two Precision Design flashes, the DSLR 300 and the DSLR 400V. The only major difference is that the 400V has an LED video light, so any information that you learn here can be applied to either flash. Let's start by looking over the various parts of the flash and getting it powered up. Here we have the shoe mount, which slides into the hot shoe on the top of your camera. It only has one point of contact here, which transmits a signal to the flash when the shutter is pressed. Because this is a universal style flash, it doesn't have the additional contacts that would allow it to communicate with your specific brand of camera. Above the shoe mount is a locking ring that, when turned, locks the flash firmly in place. Simply place it on and turn the locking ring. The back of the flash features a switch with both manual and auto modes, a ready light for when the flash is ready to fire, an auto check light, and a handy chart for figuring out which settings you should use. The front of the flash has a light sensor that helps achieve correct exposure when using either of the auto modes, and on the 400V, an LED light for shooting video. The head of the flash is where this unit really shines. With the zoom function, you can focus the beam more precisely for faraway subjects, or you can use it at a wide angle. Plus, you can tilt and swivel the head in almost any direction for use as a bounce flash, which typically produces the best photos. And of course, here on the side is the battery chamber. You'll need four AA batteries, either standard alkaline or NIMH rechargeables. Now, before we continue, using this flash requires that you become familiar with the manual controls of your camera. You'll need to know how to change your shutter speed, aperture, ISO, and how to turn the flash on and off. So please make sure you're comfortable changing settings before you begin using the flash. So, once you have the batteries installed, you have a couple modes to choose from. In manual mode, the flash will always fire at full strength when you press the shutter. So, you'll need to control exposure by manually adjusting your camera settings. You can refer to the exposure distance chart on the back of the flash to dial in the proper exposure. For example, if your subject is 13 feet away, you can use any combination of camera settings in that column for proper exposure, such as F8 and ISO 100. Your shutter speed should always be set to 1/60th of a second as a starting point. Then, adjust the zoom head to match your current focal length and fire away. You can make small changes to the exposure by adjusting your shutter speed or aperture, but the chart should give you a good place to start. Auto modes are a bit easier to use, and are preferred for close subjects in general use. In either blue or red auto mode, the flash will sense the level of ambient light and produce a burst of light that will work with the camera settings shown on the chart. For example, in blue auto mode, the flash will automatically provide proper exposure for a scene with your camera set to ISO 200 and F8. Shutter speed should again start at 1/60th. To shoot at bigger apertures, red auto mode is preferred. The 400V flash has just one auto mode. Regardless of which mode you use, the key is practice. Since every camera is different and every lighting situation has specific needs, you'll probably need to take a few shots to get your exposure dialed in. Of course, getting the right amount of light is only part of flash photography. Making that light look beautiful takes more practice and a few simple techniques and accessories. For example, when taking a portrait, pointing your flash straight at your subject will result in bright but harsh lighting and dark shadows. To soften the light, there are several things you can do. The simplest option is to attach a diffuser. This will spread the light out over a wider area, decreasing shadows and softening highlights. There are dozens of diffusers on the market, so check out Cometa.com to find one that will fit this flash. Another easy technique, one that often provides the best results, is bouncing the light. By aiming the flash up toward a large reflective surface, you can greatly reduce shadows and create soft, flattering light. Sometimes, this small attachment is all you need. This simple bouncer attaches to your flash with a few strips of Velcro and makes a huge difference in the quality of light. To spread out the light even more, you can bounce your flash off a large reflective surface like a white ceiling, a large reflector, or a poster board. A larger surface will soften the light even more, and with an off-camera reflector, you have more control over the direction of your light. Of course, keep in mind that the more you spread out the light, the more intensity it loses, so you need to adjust your camera settings accordingly, and perhaps operate your flash in manual mode to get the right exposure. As with any universal flash, getting the lighting perfect can be a bit challenging, but with a little practice and some rechargeable batteries, you'll be taking gorgeous portraits in no time, and you won't need to break the bank to do it. And of course, if you have any questions at all, call or email us, and we'll be happy to help you. Enjoy your flash.